2021 NFL Draft quarterback class is, without exaggeration, one of the best we have seen all time. This will only be the second time since 1983 that five quarterbacks go in the first round. One of those first round quarterbacks that has been talked a lot about during this draft season has been Mac Jones out of Alabama. Jones was the Alabama Crimson Tide's quarterback during their national championship run this past season when they ran the table and won it all. He's being talked about as a top 5 pick by some people, and I'm sure fans of several teams that need quarterbacks are wondering whether this guy is actually worth a top 5 pick in the draft. And yes, I'm looking at you 49ers fans. Today, I'll go through some of his film with you to talk about who Mac Jones is as a player, and whether the 49ers or any other team that needs a quarterback should be selecting him that earlier in the draft. Please be sure to hit the subscribe button to help me grow my channel, it would help me out a lot, and with that said, let's just get into the film. I'll start by talking about some of his areas of strength, and then we'll go into some of the areas of improvement. When I was watching film, it wasn't difficult at all to notice that Mac Jones' number one best trait is his accuracy. Really, the guy just does not miss throws. If he knows where he's going with the ball, then it is going to end up right where he wants to put it. It's almost unreal how accurate this guy is, and I think I can safely say he's the single most accurate quarterback in this draft class in terms of throws 10 to 15 yards from the line of scrimmage. Now, another thing that's really amazing about Mac Jones is his timing on his throws. He's able to anticipate receivers coming open, and he throws the ball to them so it's in the air just at the right moment. Like on this play here, you can see that just as his receiver comes out of his break, Jones throws the ball to him. It's textbook timing, and it's probably a result of the incredible coaching he had down there at Alabama. His experience and understanding of how to time throws and anticipate receivers coming open and coming out of breaks, it's truly special, and again, it's one of the best things that he has. Again, look at this play right here where he anticipates his receiver coming open and he leads him perfectly so that the ball drops right into his hands. Again, this is just, that's who Mac Jones is. Perfect timing, perfect accuracy within 10 to 15 yards of the line of scrimmage. So with his strengths, namely his accuracy and his timing mentioned, let's talk about some of Jones' biggest weaknesses. For one, Mac Jones had the best situation in the country last year. Alabama has about 5 offensive players that are going to be drafted in the first 2 rounds this year. Namely, he got to throw to Devontae Smith, Jalen Waddle, he got Najee Harris leading the run game, he had Alex Leatherwood and Landon Dickerson on the offensive line, and on top of that, he had the one and only Nick Saban as his play caller last year. Not to mention there are more offensive weapons on that offense that are going to be drafted next year, like John Mechie, for example. So, although Jones' stats were incredible last year, and he did have a very good year, you have to take into account that Saban's system with all that talent offensively gave him really easy reads and really easy throws to make to wide open receivers all season long. Now, the other thing about Jones that I think is a huge downside is that he really can't do anything when the play breaks down. When the pressure gets to him, or when there aren't any receivers open downfield, he can't do much. He excels when he has open receivers in a clean pocket, like I said, but when the play breaks down, he struggles to create something out of nothing. And honestly, when you look at most of the top guys in today's NFL, the top quarterbacks, they're guys who can create something out of nothing. Patrick Mahomes, Russell Wilson, Deshaun Watson, Josh Allen, they're all guys who can make plays when there's no one open. And if we're being honest, Mac Jones just isn't that guy. He's great when the system goes well and when his receivers are open, but when the play breaks down, when he has to escape the pocket, and when there's pressure in his face, he can't do anything. When the play breaks down, it breaks down with Mac Jones. Here's an example of what I mean. Look at this play where he has a wide open receiver, but there's pressure in his face, so he just misses the throw straight up. And also, a lot of the times you'll see him miss deep balls, but his receivers will adjust to it and catch it anyways, so they make him look good even though it was really a terribly placed ball. Things like this, and especially even when like the pressure's in his face and he takes sacks, there are sometimes when you say, like, if that was Patrick Mahomes, he would have done something. If that was Trevor Lawrence or Zach Wilson, he would have made a play happen on that, but that Mac Jones just can't. He doesn't do a lot when it comes to play broken down, extend the play, make something happen, something out of nothing. That's not who Mac Jones is. He can excel, again, like I said, he can excel when the system is going well, when there's open receivers, when there's a clean pocket, but when the play breaks down, it's broken down. One other thing I need to add on is that Jones is just not athletic at all. Again, when you look at the top tier quarterbacks in today's NFL, most of them are athletes, and in this year's draft class, the top 4 guys are athletes. Trevor Lawrence, Zach Wilson, Justin Fields, Trey Lance, all of them are athletic guys who can take off and run or get outside of the pocket, but that's not Mac Jones. That's just another thing that could discourage NFL GMs from drafting him early. The NFL today is developing to favor dual threat quarterbacks, guys who can take off and run for yardage. That's the reason that Lamar Jackson won MVP a couple years back. That's the reason why Kyler Murray's so dynamic. Guys who are dual threat, who can run, go outside the pocket, make plays when the play's broken down, that's who the NFL favors these days, and Mac Jones just isn't that. So, at the end of the day, after I went through all the film and evaluated him and graded him, my conclusion is that Mac Jones, he's very accurate, he's excellent at timing throws and anticipating receivers coming open. However, he's unathletic. He had a great situation at Alabama that made him look better than he really is. He can't extend plays when they're broken down, so at the end of the day, that skill set to me is just not worth a top 5 pick. I would definitely rather have guys like Justin Fields or Trey Lance over Jones, and again, that's no disrespect to Mac Jones. I like him a lot as a guy, and I think that in the right situation, he could win a lot of games. But the truth hurts, and the truth, based on my film evaluation and grading, is that Mac Jones in the NFL will always be a mediocre quarterback, lurking in that top 10 to top 15 range. So all in all, no, I don't think Mac Jones is worth a top 5 pick or a top 10 pick, and frankly, if I was a GM, I wouldn't be the one to pick him in the first round.